How's everybody doing out there? Averis here, about to play SD Gundam G Generation Genesis. So we beat Mobile Suit Gundam last time. There's tons of side stories in this game. Like, look at these are all between this one and the one I'm gonna do. Look at all these. The thing is, I've done a couple of them, and they're all like two stages, super long, condensing like 6 to 13 part OVAs into two super long missions, and they're as cool they are, they're not super fun. So I'm gonna go with the next canonical entry in the series, which is the Stardust Memories, which I actually really enjoyed. So we got land. So this takes place, I'm sure it'll say it all here. 3 years after the end of the original Gundam, back there we go, the remnants of Zeon, led by the... the Nightmare of Solemn, I think they call him. He's trying to restart the war and kill all the Fetties. The peace that would last forever was shattered. After 3 short years, yet we're still developing highly advanced super weapons. That is true. One of the key things in all this is just how absolutely arrogant and a-hole-ish every side is. Like, we've all the good guys who are pretty, you know, even tempered and normal for the most part. Like, all the higher-ups are all just complete asshats. I haven't seen Unicorn yet, but I'm sure it's the same thing. Loading. What makes this a little weird is the fact that I had the GP00, which is actually like the prototype and a side story for the ones that show up in this one. The GP01, the GP02, and the GP03. Oh, that's a cool looking ship. Torrington Base. I mean, this is a long trip from Jaburo, but they went from like... Jaburo's in like South America to Australia. I mean, even in modern times, that's not that long of a flight. Like, maybe a day. If you have a really bad flight... And these things can, you know, travel through space, so I'm sure they can go faster. Yeah, from the beginning of Gundam, that's when Zeon dropped that colony down on Earth. 500-kilometer wide crater. You can tell they're Zeons because even though they probably couldn't get access to Federation mobile suits, they decided to just do their own thing. Operation Stardust. And now we meet the hero of our story. Nope, not yet. Nope. Captain Sinopus. Wait, his name was spelled two different ways. Did you guys see that? It was spelled S-I-N on the screen, but S-Y-N down the bottom. I shall have the utmost care in transporting our super weapons. There he is, Ko Uraraki. It's essentially an improved white base. Wouldn't you like to know? So he sneaks on board and sees the two Gundams because they have Federation uniforms. That's just how easy it is. Which makes the Zeon plan all that much harder. Are ensigns typically test pilots? I mean, they're like the lowest rank you can get, or one of. He got dragged away. It's true love. Yeah, does that one use nuclear weapons? Which you have a treaty against and is actually the one thing we can't do in war in the Gundam universe? Like, no. Of course not. Why would it? That'd be stupid. See, at least he's wearing a Federation uniform. What kind of, the higher rank you are, the easier it's going to be to get around places. No one's going to bother you. It's still decent, though. Yes, let's. Those guys are like, what do we do again? Oh, that's a change of music. Right there, Sinapus, S-I-N-A. But then right there, Sanapus, S-Y-N-A-P-S-E. I knew I wasn't losing my mind. Yeah, two different translations. I mean, I should be thankful I can play this game in English at all, so it shouldn't be too hard on the translations, but that's just odd. Wait, loading the warhead? You're loading the nuclear warhead into that thing for a test run? And not like, you know, someplace else? That's just how easy it was to steal that nuclear weapon. You, is it armed? Yeah. Okay, thanks. Taken? Well, Taken's pretty explicit. Yep, there's GP2. They say Zeon? Oh, there they are. Oh, yeah. And he's gone. Now, there goes Ko in Unit 1. Nice. Yeah, she's more worried about the Gundams. Like, no, my beautiful machines! That is true. Okay, that might be tough, because I gotta worry about those other jerks down there. And nobody else is sortie. Sorry about that, I gotta get some water. Okay, so we're at 1200 and he's at 960. So the beam rifle is gonna be the strongest attack. Of course, he's got one of those too, so. Fine, if you're just gonna dodge everything, I'm just gonna get right up in your face then, sucker. He knows who I am. There we go, okay. But four turns, that's not gonna do enough every turn to do it. See, those guys are gonna be the problems. Let's see how this looks. Especially since he's defending, I'm not gonna be able to do this. Dom Tropin, what the hell is that? Let's find out, shall we? Ah, just an enhanced Dom. Well, that sucks. Okay, this is the last shot, so I have to hit him. I have to use the beam rifle. He's gonna try to dodge. 63% chance. This is an entirely luck-based mission. Yes! But luck I got. I mean, well, that's why that one's tough. It's like you have exactly four turns. You hit him every turn. You have to use the beam rifle. And if he decides to evade and dodge, you have a 63% chance of hitting the damn dude. It sucks. Ooh, south. There's Keith and the Zaku. And that's our move to the next phase. Okay. I'm assuming now we'll have a chance to do something. Oh, there they are.
Koraki. I hate him.
Oh, okay, that was... Those are the ones I hate the most. It's not about skill with that one. It's basically like, does the random number generator like you or not? Because you have exactly four turns. It will take exactly four turns if you hit, and you're not guaranteed to hit every time. So it has nothing to do with your skill. I'm going to blow up the earth. Hey, Bob. I love how it is. We have South Burning, Kodoraki, Anna Legato, and Bob. This is the first time I've ever done one of these where I've actually got a group of what appears to be actually decent assortment of mechs. Like, the white base was okay because it had a couple gun cannons and a Gundam, and the Gundam. But only the Gundam of them was, like, really good. These all looked like really decent machines. And a couple balls and some GMs. I mean, come on. Like, what does a guy want with a nuke? Are you kidding me? An ambush? Shocking. Yeah, they had trained for this. Now it's time to scramble the fairies. Is that really it? There has to be more to this. 9 units? And again, coming off like the later stages of the original Gundam game where I was going up, like we said, no fooling, six, you know, 5 to 6 to 1 on the odds. This just seems easier, I think. So I gotta have Ko destroy the Ko. Oh, there's gonna be 2 parts to this then. We're gonna do that one, then it'll be a 3rd part where we get the warning one, because we did well. So basically, we gotta smash these guys and then have Ko kill it. Simple. So I did upgrade, and one of the things I upgraded to was a... that weird-looking Gundam 5th turned into a freaking Psycho Gundam. How awesome is that? Support. Might as well do support. Animation on. So this is actually from Zeta Gundam, so it's actually from the next series in the chronology, but... It is... Oh... I was going to say, even if I don't like it, I had to get it just because I could get it. Because it is, by and large, one of the most powerful machines in, like, the series. Oh, I get to go again. That was the fuse. Now, let's do the fuse mega particle cannon. Of course, I'm sure I'm going to be burning through energy like a madman with this thing. That was the quickest kill I've ever seen in this game. It like literally looked like he was about to dodge and just stopped in his tracks and got hit by a laser cannon. Okay, enough fun with the Psycho Gundam. I still have the Bishop because I did not make that one yet because it needs level 6 to become its highest form. So I wanted to keep that one for the time being. I traded my GPO-1 out for a GPO-3. Oh, didn't kill him. Were my numbers backwards on that? It looked like I shouldn't have hit, but he should have, but yet I'm alive. Interesting. So we got that one, and we also got a Jigen. Something from the later Mobile Suit Gundams. I really like the way the Jigens look. Once again, the Gundams all look like personalized. They all have like face. That looks like that's like a unit that might actually exist in 20, 30 years. So we gotta go up there because he needs that final kill. So in the GM Desert type, I can get that. I have a Zaku 2, Federation, and a Power GM. But these are all stuff I could probably easily make. I mean, I could always play this mission again and just get them too. In the meantime, we have a Gundam 7th now. A Delta Plus. The Pixie. Whoop. And of course the Phoenix. So the Phoenix has not got its final form yet. Oh wow, can I hit it from here? May as well. Yeah, they're not moving. I don't blame them. So Code needs to kill that thing. That's the only... stipulation we have. Anybody in group attack range? Oh. Oh, that bishop has... I need to get rid of that bishop. It has horrible mobility. Let's see the GPO-3. This is actually the last one of these we could get in this series. This is basically an enhanced version of the one Ko's using right now. I love that when you hit these DOMs, they just like stop dead in their tracks, like you can feel the force. Nothing. See the Gundam 7th in action. I didn't realize I made this many Gundams. Like, that's actually the beauty of playing these games, is you don't, like, you see all this expanded universe stuff and everything, it's like, wow, there's a million of these things. And some are obviously just, like, redesigns of older ones, but, like, it's still cool to see it all. Nice, okay. Let's see the Delta Plus's beam cannon. So he's had a Delta Gundam before. Whoa! I'd love to see the reaction from like the actual characters in from the animated the anime like right now. They're like, man, I'm glad these guys are on our side. Alright, folding bazooka, let's check this out. Double bazookas? Wow. Realistically speaking, I should have done way more than 5,000. Beam Saber! Okay, I said it's a wimpy looking Beam Saber, but you know what? Effective. Ooh, he hit us. Alright, Ko, you are up. He needs to do 6,000, so let's see him do this. Down with 3 O's. Nice. Wow, see how tiny that get gauge went up? Oh my god, take forever to get this thing. Ah, there he is. In the history books from 3 years ago. Wait, how old are you? You read him in history books 3 years ago. You see some on the news or something. So just two of you. See, at least he listened to it. If that was Amuro, he would have taken off on his own. Yeah, my help. What do you need with? Sure, I'll try. I think both those statements are completely and utterly false at this point. Well then, if he's got a giant nuke cannon on his shoulder, that makes him a little powerful too. Yes, remember that, Ko. Alright, can the real fight begin now? Okay. 8. Good, the unknowns are here. Please be something cool. Nice. Ooh, Fritz helmet. Okay. Let's see what a Fritz helmet look like. Oh, Ooh, man, I can take a hit. Yeah, okay, it's pretty powerful. You can use co-status as a character shield. Two. Deal extra damage on him. Take him out, then we can collect those two and either keep them or sell them. I'm gonna probably sell them. Okay, the Delta Plus looks really awesome. Ooh! Yeah, so long, Fritz. They're like, yeah, they got us. And it's pretty strong, too, if you can't tell from the stats. Here we go, we're gonna group attack this sucker. So the Zamel looks like an actual battle. It was in the front one, but it only attacked the ship, so I couldn't actually see what it looked like or how it attacked. They ignored me. Yeah, that feels like it could do some damage. Highly impractical, except for a mortar shot, but... still effective. Ugh. Oh, it's an anti-air, no wonder it did so much damage. I kind of want my bishop to get this kill. I'm going to move my guys up here into murder range. Then next turn, we'll take it out. I kind of regret this musical choice. Like, it sounded cool when I listened to it the first time, but every time, it just kind of, whoa. This Delta Plus is like a freaking Zeta Gundam on steroids. Holy crap. Oh, he's bailing. I'm not going to catch him now. Rip attack. Just in range. Perfect. Sorry, Bob. Okay. Oh, God. It takes a lot of experience to get the thing leveled up, and it's just not a good unit. Like, what are these things? 125, 125, 125. I might stick her in one of those. Wow, these guys are actually getting some decent hits off on us. Like, the 30 and 40% are actually connecting. Ooh, land specialist. Remember, I was floating. Does that make a difference? Okay. Oh, I might be able to do it this turn. Like, I probably do a lot of cuts because I want to get this one level 8. I want to get that freaking bishop level 6 so I can just get it upgraded to the end and call it a day. Psycho Gundam. Super strong. Don't regret it. Little slow. So that's a 30, like a 32% hit chance and I made it. Just getting really lucky with these hits. Oh, finally. I mean, I don't know if I'm going to upgrade this thing because it is so freaking awesome, but I at least want to know what the next level of that actually is. Here's my plan. I'm going to group attack all these guys so I can weaken them up and then try to just do nothing but supports with the bishop and just take out all three of them just to get it finalized. Then we want to sortie this thing, like right here. I get support from this guy who can easily kill it. Ah, man, this is gonna take. So you hear me lamenting a little bit, it's just like, oh god. Like, that's the actually hardest part about this game, is leveling up your... the units you want to level up, just getting them there. Ugh, 80 more points. Come on. It's too weak to send against Gato, though. Finally, I got the Psycho Gundam level up, so... Ugh. The only thing it needs is maneuverability. Oh, it is awesomely powerful, but it is slow as ish. Okay, so Gato's taking on the Psycho Gundam, which has no close quarters weaponry. I honestly did not expect this. I thought he was going to run. I just mean it's smart, because it's attacking a unit that can't fight back. All I can do is defend, but you know what? It's still the Psycho Gundam he's attacking. I'll be fine. So gotta evade. Ooh, that's it. I actually seriously thought he was gonna do a lot more than that. Okay, can I use any skills? Alright, the three of us versus Gato. First off, Gundam. Ugh. And the Jigen. And then the bishop. This hopefully should get the bishop that last level up so I can just figure out if I'm going to use it or not. That was Palpatine fingers can actually hit. No, but he's dead, so it doesn't really matter. Well, not dead. Done. I shall be avenged! Oh, thank Christ. I said, I keep forgetting, this is a new type weapon, she's not a new type, I need to fix that. That's wrong, like taking a day off of when you play a game is like, what was I supposed to do yesterday? It's probably not important. Okay, so these guys are still level 1 and level 2, so we want them some levels up. Pinpoint. Battle on. Nice. It should do some decent damage. That's it. This thing's got some armor. I wonder if the fact that it's underwater affects my attacks at all. Wow, that was actually really close and very cool looking. Like, ow, that hurt. Now, you think that hurts? Wait till I eventually get an attack range of you. Yeah, let's see this. Man, they would crap themselves in terror if this gigantic thing strolled down the beach and just fired a beam at you. Yeah, that's about right. Jeez. I said, not much on the moving part, but dear God. I know there's an upgrade. Sorry, I stuttered. I just got my mind going a million miles a second. That gives you more... rain, like moving blocks or spaces. I think I'll invest for that for this guy if I'm gonna keep him around, which I might just do to see what the upgrade path for the freaking Psycho Gundam is.
Stage clear.
Yeah, I mean, we pretty much just like I said, I had a mission to upgrade certain machines, so that's all I was trying to do. Yep. Oh, Keith. Yay. He's not bad. Oh, automatically generate... Ooh, Gundam Jack complete. What's the quest? Oh, wow. So by beating Gato, I got this. Automatically gain 5% energy every turn. That's really good. Maybe something to invest in. Okay, so here's the Delta Plus. I can get a Gundam Mark III, obviously. A Hyakushiki. I knew this thing was based on the Hyakushiki. A plain old Delta Gundam, or whatever this is, which is what I'm going for. Level, one more level, I have it. Hyakushiki would be pretty good, too. It has a very interesting upgrade path as well. But there's two things for the moment of truth. First off, Phoenix Unleashed. Finally. All of that. And I can get a Haro for an XL Haro. And oh man, but when you upgrade this Haro to level 20, it becomes a freaking murder device. Look at those stats. Ugh. Don't think I'm gonna go for it though, but oh man. Well played, game. Well played. So there's that one. So we got here. Ooh, Psycho Gundam Mass Production. Something else is extra large. See, like, so these things, I'm interested in seeing what the hell these things are. Especially that guy. So I'll be leveling that thing up. The Jigen. GM3, obviously. Some unknown ones that are all really good. Pixie, I can't really upgrade that thing any further. Same thing with the Gundam 5th, but it's just a good machine. So I can buy other ones. Same thing with the Alex. I can get the Chobham armor, but it brings up a new ability, but it brings up its defense. But I like the way it is. Okay, so here is Bishop. This thing turns into a freaking... A blip block. Man, that's actually really good. I lose the ability to use this thing on the land, but you know what? It'd be the same if I got the Psycom thing here too. So see, that's how I got the F2. So that's why I didn't bother doing Keith's thing. That's an F2 Federation color. So, but this thing is interesting. But I have 100,000, so I can actually buy a decent machine now from my list of murder devices. So I will probably do that. In the meantime, 1 second. Sorry. In the meantime, thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this one. So we're going to get going with Stardust Memories. So far, so good. I mean, that was compared to the last fights of the normal Gundam show. These were not that difficult, which was good. It's nice to take it easy for a while and have a nice decisive victory for a change and not a sweating 2 hour long marathon of, oh my God, am I going to do this or not? So, and I like Stardust Memories. So good. These machines are getting good. The kids are good. I have gotten a lot of tips, which I do appreciate. I really do. They really have helped me figure out some things, even if I keep forgetting a thing or two here or there. But I do appreciate it. But anyway, once again, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this. If you liked the video, the like button, like all my videos, feel free to subscribe. No pressure. If there's anything I need to be better, anything I want to play, or in this game, any particular storyline I'm going to go through, let me know. I'll do my best to accommodate, and I'll see you guys later.